Make sure that your level is aligned with the floor for which you want to model the walls. Open the point cloud in floor plan view. Edit the view range so that walls are clearly visible with minimum interference from other objects. We generally prefer to keep the view range between 5 feet and 5.5 feet above the floor level. To extract a wall, go to the Scan to BIM tab in Revit and click on Fit Wall button. Next, click on 3 points of the wall that you want to extract. The first 2 points should lie on the same side of the wall and should be as away from each other as possible, preferably lying close to the opposite edges of the wall. Choose the third point on the second side of the wall. It is needed to calculate the wall's width. Once you have selected all the 3 points, the add-in will display a pop-up. The pop-up shows the floor plan on the left where you can verify the fit between the extracted wall and the point cloud. On the right side, you can select the base and top constraints, offset and height. You want to select the side of the wall as either interior or exterior. This is the side of the wall corresponding to the first point you picked. Below you'll see the detected width of the wall along with a list of wall types that are already loaded in the document, arranged by the best fit first. Delta column shows the discrepancy between the detected wall width and the width of the wall type. Select the wall type that you want to insert and click on the OK button. Wall is inserted. Sometimes you would have scanned only one side of the wall and the other side of the wall is missing from the point cloud. In this case, pick the first 2 points of the wall as you normally do and instead of picking the third point, press Escape. The add-in will display another pop-up. The big difference is that the add-in doesn't know the actual width of the wall and hence there is no delta column. Second, there is a toggle button to switch on which side of the picked points you actually want to create the wall. Notice that you see only one wall type in the list now. That's because by default the add-in will show you only those wall types which have already been used in the project. If you want to select a new wall type, uncheck the Show Only Previously Used Wall Types checkbox. Click on the OK button to insert the wall. To join the walls, you can use Revit's Trim to Extend tool.